put the tail of the leather this year. Let us make this one. Day 2. I mean, carve up the tag. I got this. Okay, sir.
Okay.
Scrub Lords versus.
System link.
Night Watch, right?
Huh.
Night Watch. Okay. আমি আছে আমাদের ওই চ্যান আমাদের নেভার প্র্যাকটিস এর চ্যানেলে দিছি ওকে চেক ইট
ওকে
আমি একটু মুভমেন্ট মুভমেন্ট করি দেখো কোনো এক্সট্রা সাউন্ড হচ্ছে নাকি আমাকে গতবার আলু বলতেছিল যে এটা খুব বাজে সাউন্ড আসছে সো আমি ওগুলো দেখো ইফ ইট ওয়ার্কস ওকে
আমি আমার মাইকটা মিউট করে
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ শিওর শিওর ইটস ফাইন ইটস ফাইন
Every death comes honor. With honor, redemption.
I just sound down crispy. My god, you're angry, Dilla.
Okay.
Which you put a channel tag.
Hello, so you can actually, I could not even hear you come in. Anyways, I'm stream cut this way. Dekto. As for sound as an aki. না না মিউট মিউট করার দরকার না আমি প্র্যাকটিস মোডে আছি জাস্ট সি ইফ মাই সাউন্ড টাউন হচ্ছে নাকি আজকে
দাম কোনটা লিংক
ওই যে কালকে যেটা দিছিলাম
আরে 10 সেকেন্ডের মতন লেট দেখি দিলে
হ্যাঁ হবে
মানে কি স্ট্রিম ল্যাগ করতেছে নাকি গেমটা পিছায় আছে
না 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 পিছায় আছে
পিছায় তো ইচ্ছা করেই থাকবে ইভেন OBS এর বিল্ট ইন এ 2 সেকেন্ড ডিলে দেওয়া আছে আই থিং আমার লিগের এই জিনিসটা অ্যাট লিস্ট ভালো ছিল 3 মিনিট তেমনি পিছানো ছিল
পান্তা পাওয়া যেত না স্পয়েল হইতাম 3 মিনিটে গেম শেষ হইতো আচ্ছা
আমি তো এখনো ফার্স্ট ইয়ার মনে আছে আমি গাধাদের মতো সবাই বলতাম ভাই কি বলে জানি তুমি ওখানে ওয়ার্ডটা ভাঙতেছ না কেন ওখানে প্লেয়ার বসে আছে মারতেছ না কেন সাউন্ড কেমন সাউন্ড কি ঠিক আছে আমি কিন্তু এর চেয়ে বেশি তো স্ট্রিম করতে পারবো বাট আমি খামাখাই করতেছি না আমার 1080 বন্ধ হয় না আমার পিসি চলতেছে 140 মানে 144 পিতে বাট আমি হচ্ছে বাট আমি কমা মানে স্ট্রিম করতেছি 720 তে আচ্ছা ওদেরটা হইলে ইনভাইট মি আমি ততক্ষণ ব্যাকগ্রাউন্ডে কিছু গান ছাড়ি
আচ্ছা আপনাকে দান স্পেক্টেটর ইনভাইট দিয়ে রাখি ওরা কুইক প্লেতে গেছে
ওয়াও ওদের ইনভাইট দিয়ে রাখো আর ওই যে কি বলা জানি গ্রুপে পোস্ট দিয়ে রাখো ও থ্যাংক গড আমি হচ্ছে ভিডিওতে কি বলা জানি উইন্ডোজটা দেখতে পারে না মানুষ তাহলে দে কুড সি হোয়াট আই এম হোয়াট আই হ্যাভ ইন দিস ফোল্ডার রাইট নাও
আচ্ছা লিংকটা গ্রুপে দিয়ে দিই
ওকে
কাদের কাদের গেম?
কাবাব এন্ড নাইট ওয়াচ।
নাইট ওয়াচ জানি কোনটা?
আমাদের সেকেন্ড ম্যাচ যাদের ছিল। ও
কাবাব
এর পাফে আছে না? পাফে
নাম স্ট্রিম করতেছে আলো। ও
আই ভোট ফর কাবাব আই থিংক। ওদের কোয়ালিটি একটু ভালো ছিল।
এই যে মামা ভাই দেখছেন পাফে আর নাই দেখ। আর আমরা আগে খেয়াল করলে তো ওই প্লেয়ার আসতোই না, কারণ অলরেডি সাতটা প্লেয়ার ছিল। সাবস্টিটিউট কি জন্য দেওয়া হয়েছে? তাদের একটা প্লেয়ার সমস্যা হলো আর সে পুরো সাবস্টিটিউট নিছে।
সেটাই আমার এমন না যে মানে রেজিস্ট্রেশনের সময় বললো কিছু বলতাম না, আই উডন্ট হ্যাভ আ প্রবলেম।
হ্যাঁ
এনিওয়ে দ্যাটস ফাইন, ইটস আমরা স্ট্রিম করতেছি সো।
আর সেমিফাইনাল তো হইতেছে। আচ্ছা আমরা মডিফিকেশনে চলে যাই। আচ্ছা
তোমরা গেম চ্যানেলে ওটা যাও, আমি স্ট্রিমিং একটা চলে যাচ্ছে।
ওকে
আমাদের ম্যাচ তো পরে রাইট, সো রাখাত কি ক্যাশিং করবে? রাখাতকে জিজ্ঞেস করে দেখতে পারো, হি ক্যান স্ট্রিম।
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ হয়তো হয়তো ও পেজন ফোন করছিল।
ওকে ওকে
ওকে ইনভাইট মি।
আচ্ছা গেম আছে, অ্যাড প্লেয়ার কাবাব এখন আসে নাই, একটু আগে ছিল, এখন কিছু রেস্ট নিচ্ছে।
কাবাব আসে নাই। Is it streaming? Bamba, is it streaming already?
Huh? Yeah, yeah it is.
How you stream? I'm eating.
Koi jon dekhte pepe korlo ek jon dekhe na tin jon dekhte chhe. Acha
yeah I am streaming. আচ্ছা কোথায় স্ট্রিম লিংক পোস্ট করছো?
ইয়া
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ স্ট্রিম লিংক গ্রুপে পোস্ট করছি প্লাস ওদের মেসেজ করে দিছি।
ওটা কি আর্টোরিয়াস এর এইটা থেকে পেজ থেকে?
না 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 মামা ভাই নিচে করতেছে, ওর নেট ইস্যু হয়েছে করতে পারতেছে না।
আপা ম্যাডাম সি আর
পাফি কি করে? পাফি কেন এখানে? আচ্ছা আর্টোরিয়াসও করবে। কাবাবের টিম ম্যাচ আমারে জিজ্ঞেস করে যে কাবাব কোথায়। আর ফাকিং কিডিং মি,
কাবাবের টিম ম্যাচ কি কাবাবের মধ্যে নেই?
হ্যাঁ আর্টোরিয়াসও করবে, দুইটা হবে। আচ্ছা নির্ঝর
সবাই আসছে আই থিংক।
হ্যাঁ মামা ভাই,
যা
হ্যাঁ সমস্যা হয়েছে, পাফি পারছি রিমুভ করতে বলতেছে, এখন কি রিমুভ করে দিব? স্ক্র্যাপ লোডার কিন্তু নাইট আছে বলতেছে রিমুভ না করতে
না, বাট দ্যাট ইজ কমপ্লিটলি ট্রু, টিমমেটস কেন স্পেক্টেট করবে?
তাহলে ওদেরকে কি একটু বলেন, ওরা চেলেচেলি করতেছে,
আমি স্ট্রিম করতেছি, আমি এটার মধ্যে কেন যাব?
আমি আমি বলতেছি।
ও আচ্ছা আচ্ছা, ঠিক আছে বলো।
ইটস কমপ্লিটলি ট্রু, এটা খামাখা এগুলো করা কোনো মানেই হয় না।
ওকে বলো যে স্ট্রিম দেখতে। ঝামেলা হচ্ছে, থাক সমস্যা কি। স্টার্ট দাও ড্রাফট, স্টার্ট দাও
ড্রাফট, ওদের লিঙ্ক পাঠাই দিচ্ছি, ওরা স্টার্ট করে নেয়। আর স্ক্র্যাপ লোড পালতেছে অনুবিস, ইলিয়াস পালতে দিছে নাইট।
Okay, whose sound is that?
Aman.
Achha, stream at time mein, I think we should move to a different channel, Mamu.
Sure.
Stream at a channel, chale to.
You're fine.
আমাদের ভয়েস কি রকম আসছে আমি তো জানিও না চেক
করতে। You can check my stream. আমি অল অন করে রাখছি অলরেডি।
আমি অলরেডি ইউটিউবে আছে। Are you sure? It to game a master volume to come here so that we can cast right.
What?
Apparently, গতকালকে বলতেছিল যে master volume টা মানে game এর master volume টা কমাইতে and caster দের voice বাড়াতে because আমাদের voice নেই.
মানে আমাদের voice টা কম ছিল নাকি জোরে ছিল?
না কম ছিল. সে বলতেছিল master volume টা মানে game এর
volume. হ্যাঁ, that I get it. আচ্ছা, হ্যাঁ, এটা আরো কমাই দিচ্ছে.
আচ্ছা, রিউজিন কোডস ক্যাডো সেটা কেউ কি রিমুভ করে দিব?
আপ টু ইউ, ওগুলো তো আমাদের প্লেয়ার আর না দেখতে চাইলে না দেখো,
ওরা ওরা সমস্যা যদি আবার পরে এনে সমস্যা
না এখন আপাতত
ইটস ফাইন ইটস ফাইন থাকুক ওদের হইছে ড্রাফটিং
না এখনো বাকি আছে ডুয়ার্ডো নেপাল রুট 66 হানামুরা এখন অল একটা বাকি সবাই কি ওয়েসিস পড়তে
নিউজে Who the hell is this Asaduzzaman Pavel bhai? On YouTube?
I don't know. Why? Ki bolte
sir? Anush chon eto stingy keno? Annoying noise kichen noise stream e to kono noise nei. Never mind.
Can you actually hear any noise?
No. Okay. মানে বাঙালিদের খাইতে দিলে শুতে চাই
আইকন ওয়ার্ল্ড
ওকে ওকে দ্যাটস গুড আ গুড ম্যাপ
আইকন ওয়ার্ল্ড এই তো
কালকের ম্যাচটা মজা হয়েছিল দেখি এখন কি হয়
ওইটা তো শুধু এক্সাইটেড জন্য মজা ছিল
হ্যাঁ বাট স্টিল ইট ওয়াজ ফান টু ওয়াচ
Greetings! Oh!
Yes.
আচ্ছা মামা আপনার মনে হয় যে মাইক্রোফোন বুস্ট করা
আমার বুস্ট অফ করা
বুস্ট অন করে
কি নয়েজ আসতেছে এখানে তো আমি চেক করলাম কোনো নয়েজই তো নেই একটা হিস আসবে ওটা তো আসবে স্বাভাবিক একটা ব্যাপার এতজনের মাইক্রোফোন এখানে
ওরা রেডি ইজ ইট এনি বেটার নাও দেখো তো
রেকর্ডিং করার সময় যে একটা সাউন্ড আসে না আচ্ছা গাইস আই লিভ তাহলে
বাই
গুড লাক
তোমরা স্টিমারে চলে যাও তাহলে
ওকে মুভ আস টু দি আদার ওয়ান
ওকে স্টিম মোটো
All right here, ladies and gentlemen, we're here on for a match between Nightwatch and the Scrublords. Now, two very strong teams in the tournament, probably the strongest teams in the tournament. This is going to be one hell of a match to watch out for. Never stop fighting for what you believe. We're going to see the Nightwatch on defense running a triple tank composition. Xerix on the soldier there, pretty standard, nothing extraordinarily different. And we're gonna be seeing a pretty aggressive comp coming out from the Scrub Dodge there with the King Kebab on the Pharah and Blitz on the Genji. Of course, Blitz very well known for his Genji play. This is gonna be one fun match. What do you say, Mamba? What do you think how it's gonna be?
I hope at least it's not gonna be a stomp like yesterday. I just hope we're gonna get to see a very good match today.
Well, we know for a fact that these are perhaps the two strongest teams in the tournament. I mean, let's just hope that we really should be having a show here.
Yep, that's all we can hope for.
All the magic begins! Scrub Lords on the attack! Blitz going in, getting a peek, probably gonna relay some information back to his team about what they're running. King Kebab trying to go for the Pharah flank. Let's see how it works out for him. Has he been spotted out? No, he has not been spotted out. Takes it to the air. Focuses down Max Virgil and Xerux. But instantly gets taken out by Xerux there. But Blitz comes in. Superior Ninja takes out Max Virgil. And he's doing work there, trying to dodge Racy and the hook. Tough battle to take against a Roadhog there. Racy's gonna have to take a breather. He's getting focused down. Can the hook connect? Yes, it connects. But he does not finish off. Blitz finishes him off along with health from One Punch Man. And he already has a Dragon Blade. Can he clear it? Can he clutch it for his team? And they do take it rather solidly, actually.
Genji just chipped away at the backline and Roadhog for a long time.
It's a fantastic play there from Scrub Lords over here. Now where are they going to set up? They're not setting up on the high ground. They are setting it up on the low ground. They're preferring to stay there on the ground, hoping to stop the cart as it pushes through. King Kebab is moving forward, trying to do some chip damage with the Pharah there. Blitz goes in again! Doesn't get hooked, but he manages to go out. King Kebab is trying to play a little passively with the Pharah there, trying to do some chip damage and build up towards the ultimate, but he's nowhere close to that barrage. He is not doing a lot of work for his team.
But I don't think he ulted last time, did he?
No, he did not. 58%. You know, pretty much 2 minutes into the map, that's not really a lot of damage done from the Pharah there. But he is charging up. He's at 88 now. He's doing a lot of work now. Can he get a pick? One Punch Man is down. Sparta takes out Racy. It's a self-destruct. Duke gets two in the back. Taz gets down Duke. Dark Angel clears up Sparta. Xerux pops the tech visor, clears out Blitz. And that's a hold. Quite a lot of ultimates committed there, but from both sides. But I think at the end of the day, the Night Watch kind of stands tall and stands strong in that push there. And we see Max Virgil with the sound barrier. That's gonna be that potentially could hold up. Oh, Kebab takes out three. He takes out Max Virgil before he can even use the sound barrier. They're cleaning up.
That was a very good
three
man.
One solid push over there. My ultimate is ready. Xerux has switched over to the Pharah. He does not prefer a soldier in this case. Now, given the fact that Kebab's Pharah has been working pretty effectively so far and causing a lot of problem for the triple tank composition, he does not prefer the soldier. He doesn't want to counter the Pharah with a soldier. I don't know what he's doing there, but we'll see how it works out for them.
Maybe they believe that their Pharah can still do better than Kebab, who knows, but...
But then again, you know, to counter a Pharah with a Pharah, that requires a lot of time, right? And with a game like Overwatch, where time is everything, Max Virgil stalling in, and there you go, that's right there. This is exactly what I meant.
And exactly as you were saying that, King Kebab was the one
they did
that
not
actually...
prefer countering the Pharah. They're letting her do as she pleases.
Well, they have three ultimates right now. Two from their tanks and one from... Let's see what they do here.
And comes the Zenyatta ulti, but they're naded! Can they capitalize on this? Manard goes down. It's the Anagon. There's One Punch Man goes down to... Racy, does he? He does not! Racy does not finish up the Zenyatta! How does that even happen? Kebab with another barrage.
Kills two,
it doesn't really get much, but then again, they are pushing.
Well, he ends up getting one of the healers on the tank, so there's that.
Xerux is getting pushed back by Duke, and there it is. This is exactly like the game between Never Practice and Scrub Lords. Duke completely focuses out the Pharah and manages to do the job that a soldier is supposed to be doing. He did give hand me my ass back to me.
I guess his girlfriend will be very proud to see this tomorrow.
In a way. Xerox is going in. He's got the barrage. Is he going to do it? Is he going to do it? He's getting focused by the Zenyatta. He's got Discord on him. No, he does not get it. Kebab is still doing work. He's going to the front lines and he's taking, he's forcing the tanks back.
And he
actually brings out the Winston. Racer brings out the Winston, but it's not effective. Like I say, the Pharah is doing work for them and they have no answer for the Pharah.
The Pharah has a barrage, but she dies immediately after ulting. While on this
side, the Transcendence gonna keep everybody healthy. Will the team be able to clean up?
While on
Blitz
this
gets
side,
focused down by Racer over there.
This
is a Graviton, panic Graviton.
Much
is
well.
There any follow-up? No! They capped the point! 2:43 left on the clock. That is a fantastic time to have on a map like Iconvolk.
Exactly. At least the last point is the one that's hardest to push, but they did it on quite a good time.
There's a pretty bad nano boost there from Manart onto Duke over there. He popped the nano onto Duke when he was in the baby form, but that wasn't something to be worried about. The Graviton came out from Dark Angel over there, but it was very nicely countered, and there was no follow-up. His entire team had died around him.
I guess we're going to see a different style of play this time from the blue team, so let's see what they do.
Let's see. Racy's on the Tracer, Max, Virgil on the Mercy, Xerix is going on the Pharah. So if they're going for the Pharah-Mercy combination, Blitz is on the Soldier. He's a very damn good Soldier, and they have the Zenyatta to discord the Pharah and the Mercy and easily burst her down if possible. But then again, they're also running a Symmetra. King Kebab is running a Symmetra. Let's see how this works out. With a mobile composition like Tracer and Pharah with so much verticality, the Symmetra could be a problem. But then again, you never know. We've seen some pretty solid counters, but they have not been able to answer.
True.
Duke's not going to be running the D.Va. He's preferring to go with a Roadhog here.
I don't think in the last two games I've seen him play anything other than a D.Va.
Me neither. Let's see how the switch works out for them. Dark Nightwatch is going with the usual Reinhardt and Zarya combination. Well, we know for a fact that the Graviton Barrage can be a very deadly combination. But we also a combination, one of those few combinations that can actually eat through a Transcendence and do a lot of damage. We'll see how this pans out for them.
But I think on this side, the offense, a Pharah is much better. So
definitely. Let's see. Is Zerg going for the flank? No, he does not go for the flank. He is waiting here, trying to chip damage from the choke. We'll have to see how this works up. Turrets are coming into action.
He should first take
down
Zerg the turret.
Has been brought down
Pharah.
Pretty low, but he gets healed up.
That was a good
and
kill.
And King Kebab gets taken down by Xerox over there, but Blitz gets held of him. Dark Angel cleans up on One Punch Man. Blitz going to take down on Taz. Racy gets a work done on Blitz as well. This is going both ways. This can be anyone's fight over here at this point. Racy just trying to stay alive, weaving in and out, do work. Sparta's getting focused down. That's a take. That's a take. Dreadlord takes up most of the kills. He finished the delivers the final blows there. Interesting. That's a very clean push as well. Scrappy, but sort of cleaned up a bit in the end over there.
But I think they did it on at least 4 or 5 seconds faster, didn't they?
Perhaps. Now, this area is a little tough to push. But then again, depends on who utilizes the verticality of this map. Whoever does it better will come out victorious in this particular passage. Now, this is a very deadly map to be going up against a Pharah if he doesn't get focused down. The concussive blast can easily focus down and throw you off the map. You're a good Pharah, and if you know how to utilize that concussive blast over there. And they've taken control of the high ground. Blitz and Sparta up on the high ground alone, however. His rest of the team is down there below. I don't know what they're doing over here. What's their plan? But I'm not sure if it's going to work out too great for them. But
Blitz
so far, so good.
Xerox.
Blitz goes down on the low ground. The Transcendence comes up. The Earth Shatter comes up. Is there going
to
be follow-up?
They're only
is
able
there
to kill one kid first until now.
Blitz takes out Max Virgil. Sparta takes out nobody, actually. But Duke, on the other hand, cleans up Taz. And that's a hold, actually. They are holding.
Dark Angel throughout that whole fight, he had like 100% energy.
And he got nothing from that Graviton, however, but then again, we know Zenyatta's Transcendence can definitely very easily clear out any damage coming in from the Graviton. Zergs goes in for the Barrage, takes out two, King Kabob takes out Racy, Dark Angel takes out Mannert, and Blitz. That's a clear up. One Punch Man is getting focused down here by Zergs and gets taken down. And that's a push from Nightwatch. They're pushing forward. They're very, very, very close to this choke point. Checkpoint. Racy pops out. Duke pops out the whole hog. But gets nothing. He takes off Taz, but the point has been taken. I don't know what Duke was doing over there, but I don't know why he was even standing inside over there trying to pop out the whole hog.
If the rest of his team was here, this corridor would have been a very good place to use his ult, which he had up back then.
This is a scrappy fight. I don't know why Scrubloads are insistent on just keeping on contesting this fight when the payload can just easily move through and their spawn and Nightwatch has the spawn advantage. Sparta is way out there in the front. He can be easily focused down and taken out by the team. But Duke comes in back with the signature D.Va. Give it a little extra health to that shield with the defense matrix. But unfortunately, he's not even with his Reinhardt at the moment, and the shield is getting focused down completely. Dark Angel has another Graviton Surge. Racy has a Pulse Bomb. This could be very nasty. It's a combination that can totally bypass Transcendence, even the One Punch Man has a Transcendence.
But that was a good ult.
Kabob clears out. But you do realize, right? Their spawn is right there. They have the spawn advantage. Taz charges off the map. I don't think that was part of the plan. My tactical visor is charging. I personally think that they should back up a little bit because Nightwatch definitely has a spawn advantage. And they have 5 ultimates to their name.
A single ult to the backline by Racy would have just disoriented the whole fight. See?
Racy used the Pulse Bomb earlier, but that comes from nothing! They have the nano boost. Will they get something out of this? They do, somewhat. They do. Taz clears up 3. Clears up on Mannert and One Punch Man. Duke throws us a self-destruct there. Does it get anybody? No, it does not. Xerox clears up Sparta. Duke is the only one here. Is it getting focused down? Kabob switches over to the Zarya's, asking everybody to group up. Racy gets taken out by Mannert over there. It's a 5v6 right now. They're still insistent on pushing, however, the payload is so close to getting finished off into this map. Zerg takes out 2 with the Deadeye! How does that even get somebody? Kabob takes out Dead, but Zerg takes out another one, takes out Blitz. Kabob gets taken out, Sparta is low. Will he be focused down? Yes, he is. One Punch Man is the only one left, he's not contesting. Duke comes into contest, but he is getting focused down. And gets a Pulse Bomb stuck to him and he's out of his mech. Blitz brings out the Reaper, Duke is low, Blitz is low, he's getting shielded by his Zarya shield. Will they be able to hold? Will they be able to take anything? Kabob gets slept but instantly gets waken up. Sparta is trying to do work, tries to take out Taz, but has to get on the defensive position there. It's all going blue, Mamba, it's all going blue. There comes the Graviton Surge, will this be the closure? There comes
yes.
The Earth Shatter.
And
this
they
might
have
just be the closure, and they take it. 2 minutes.
2 minutes on the dot.
2 minutes to their clock. 2 minutes 43 seconds from Scrublords. Two minutes to Dark Angel. A little extra 43 second advantage over there, but we know for a fact that 43 second advantage can be significant. We'll see how this match pans out right now. This has been a very close and intense match. Both teams finishing up very nicely and very good time on Eichenwald, actually. I mean, we know for a fact the Scrublords did finish on 43 seconds extra, and that might just give them an edge, but on a map like Eichenwald, anything can happen.
Exactly, but we have to say, the game till now has been hella fun to watch.
Definitely. It's been, some of the fights have been scrappy, some of the fights we've seen 5v6 fights, and they actually, it was ballsy of Nightwatch part, actually, like, you know, they went into a fight without Racy, the Tracer falling in really early in the fight. They went in, 5v6 and they clutched that fight. I mean, and Xerox picked up two with the Deadeye in the end. I don't even know how that even happens when do you have a Reinhardt solidly holding the shield up close and up front in front of
you. I really wish Dark Angel just stuck to that Bastion pick.
That would have been really, really, really cool to have. But then again, 2 minutes to the clock. Can't really be taking risks anymore. Tried and trusted Zarya. They're going with single Tracer. D.Va, Reinhardt.
I think the Tracer already pushed in. Yeah, the Tracer is already on their
back
line.
Tracer's going in on the back. He's harassing the back line. Is he going to get a pick? He does get a pick. King Kebab gets taken out by a charge from Taz out of nowhere. Racy has to recall out of the fight. Xerox takes out Blitz. One Punch Man takes out Racy. That was one takeout from... That was a ballsy play from a Zenyatta on Tracer. But doesn't matter. Nightwatch is cleaning up. Deku's the only one left in point, and it's going to be a take. That was smooth. Racy falling to the Zenyatta there didn't really matter at all.
He was able to hit a lot of people at the back.
The Tracer did the job, I think. He just went in, did chip damage, and the team just followed up and went in and followed up and just went in on the cleanup duty over there. Now, as you see, Race is still going in the back. Backline, just trying to harass them as much as they can. And fires and takes out Kebab with the pulse bomb there.
No one hasn't noticed him. He's he got free damage for 4 seconds before he was noticed. And he's coming back
He's going back again. They have no answer for this Tracer there. And the payload's pushing. They're not even on the low ground contesting. Blitz is the only one on the low ground, and he gets taken down. That's only what you're gonna get when you get separated from the rest of your team as a Reaper. You're not a mobile. Again, you're a Tracer. And they have a grab up already. They have a self-destruct. They have a grab. This could be ugly. This could be very ugly for the Scrub Lords. Racy pops up, Duke pops up self-destruct, and it gets two! And we're up to overtime. Xerox takes a two in the back line. Sparta throws in an Earth Shatter. Are they gonna be able to clear it up? Xerox has got the Nano Boost, but Duke has more heal pull over there. He's actually doing work. Racy gets Sparta out with the Pulse Bomb there. Is it gonna be a take? Blitz is doing work. Taz gets another. Is there anybody on the payload? No, there's no one in the payload! Oh my god, they almost had the fight, but everybody left the payload!
But they went so damn far, man.
But you have to realize Scrub Lords have 2 minutes 43 seconds extra on that clock, and that might just be what they need to, just take the point and take this map. But I think that was a very, very, very careless play over there. They left the payload. Everybody, Taz charged and went away somewhere else. And Racy left the payload as well, and the overtime just ticked down. Obviously, as you know, if you've been playing familiar with the game, the longer the overtime, the faster it goes down as soon as you leave the payload. But once again, we see the triple tank composition coming out from Night Watch. Racy on the Soldier, Dreadlord on the Ana, and Max Virgil on the Lucio. Kebab and Blitz once again on the deepest rolls. Kebab going for the Pharah, Blitz going for the Genji. Once again, a very mobile and aggressive comp, especially with given the fact that Duke is running the D.Va, a very mobile tank as we know. Sparta on the Trident, trusted Reinhardt, Mannert, and One Punch Man on the Ana and Zenyatta respectively.
It all depends on if Blitz can do the same thing he did in the first part.
Oh, for sure. I mean, eyes are going to be definitely on Blitz. I mean, he has been a star player in this tournament, perhaps. As a matter of fact, his Genji has been outstanding. His Genji has been terrific. I do not have enough adjectives to, describe his Genji because he's just so fucking damn good on it. Just reflect some of the damage back. He's just going to take a peek. Kebab once again going for the flank. Xerox focuses down. Focuses numb, but he's got Duke with him over there. He's doing work. But he gets taken out by Racy, but Mannert gets a pick on the Reinhardt. That's a big pick, and the rest of the team is just flowing in. This might just be it. Blitz takes on Racy. Now it's gonna be snowballed for him. The rest of the Nightwatch are coming in. They're doing work. They're stalling this out. No kills are going in. Sparta takes on Max Virgil. Duke takes on Dark Angel. That should be That should be a take. That is clean. That is very, very, very clean. And look at the timing. They have 1 minute and 40 seconds left on the clock just to push the payload there. And look at Kebab. He's already gone forward. He's already trying to create some space for his team so that, you know, they can push ahead.
They already have three all stacked up already. They have one for both the
healers.
They
have the nano boost. They have the dragon blade. They have the self-destruct. They have the support ultimates up. This fight could be nasty. And look at Nightwatch. They are nowhere close to any ultimate except for the sound barrier. Max Virtual could just very much clutch it with the sound barrier over there. This is look at that. The payload's just moving. There's not even contesting. They're just contesting on the final checkpoint.
And Blitz already has his ult.
But they're native. They cannot heal. They cannot heal. There comes the Earth Shatter. Duke takes out one. Blitz takes out another. And that Xerox takes out King come up in midair. Blitz is still alive. How is the Genji still alive and not getting focused? And they cleared it up, and Scrub Lords take Eichenwald.
That was a nail biter till the end. My God.
I mean, I've said it time and time again that Blitz is a fantastic Genji, and if you don't have an answer for him, he is just going to eat you up. Simple as that. That was a fantastic, fantastic game to watch. Scrub Lords once again proving that they are definitely one of the strongest teams in this tournament to look out for.
He waited until the last second for the ult to be finished from Zenyatta.
Epic. 100%. Someone needs to show how it's done.
That's an insane amount of healing done from both the supports. Just look at the damage block from Sparta on the Reinhardt. Definitely did his job there. 34,000 damage done, and the Ana with the 13,000 healing. That's the amount of healing that you should generally get from an Ana in any team. And Manart has been doing some fantastic job just nailing down those healing darts along with One Punch Man.
I guess for now we're going to take a break.
Suppose so. The next map is going to get decided. Of course, Scrub Lords with the win, they get a map pick. And we'll see how this one goes.
I'm going to stop the stream for now. No. I will. It's on now.
Let me know when you're a go.
Yeah, I'm going to go. Your volume up so they should be able to hear.
Ricky Mon, what the sub change with this? Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we're here on Nepal. It was a best of three competitive format. And we know Scrublords had an amazing victory in Eichenwald there against Nightwatch, and this is it. This is their moment. If they win this map, they win this round, but of course if Nightwatch comes back with a reverse sweep, they might just be able, we're gonna go on a tiebreaker in another control point map, and gonna be decider of the series of who takes the series, who takes this round actually. Now we have a swap here. Puffy Peric coming in with the Genji again. He's shown some extremely good performance there on the Genji, but look at that. The brawling has already started, and it's all going red. Scrublord clears out the map. Blitz going in for Max Racy over there on the Lucio and clears him out. He is out, and they cap the point. What was that? They came in like a wave, and that was a team kill right there.
It feels more like they were not ready for this.
I don't know, maybe the swap came in from the Puffy Peric over there might have just given the extra edge in this tournament, but it sounds like it's not really working out for them quite much. It's a scrappy fight again. Blitz already has a Dragon Blade, but gets taken out by Taz. Gets nothing out of it. There, it's a 5v6 now. Can they capitalize on it? Dark Angel gets One Punch Man. Sparta throws down an Earth Shatter, gets Dark Angel on the ground, and he takes him out. Takes out Racy as well. They're getting focusing down Xerux on the baby D.Va over there. King Kebab is doing trying to do work on the Zarya. Throws in a Graviton. But Xerux gets into the mech, takes out Taz, takes out Duke, Puffy Perk takes out King Kebab, and it's a hold. Blitz gets taken out and they turn it back at 50%. But look at that, have you seen the stall and the exchange of ultimates really got them up all the way to 50%, and they just have to, like, you know, have two of these fights and they're gonna take the map. Now, but then again, look at this. We see the Nano Blade combination, and we see the Earth Shatter. Scroblords are going into a fight with no ultimates over. They do not have any ultimate advantage, and none of them are close. One Punch has a... And there it is! There it is! But takes up Manart. Puffy takes... King Kebab takes up Puffy, nonetheless, through a Nano Boosted Genji. Dreadlords gets focused down here by Blitz. Can he take her out? Takes out, pops out a Dragon Blade to clear up.
But he still takes out three.
He does his job. He has clearly done his job over there. Puffy has to fall back there. He is without teammates and he is low on health. Just look at that! They went into the fight with no ultimates and Blitz pulled out a clutch Dragon Blade and they totally turned the fight around. Now they have a Graviton and D.Va bomb. This could get ugly. We have to see how this burns out. But Richard, look at that! Sparta lands an Earth Shatter on Dark Angel. He had the Graviton. He goes down and he gets no chance to use that Dragon Blade. Sorry, that Graviton bomb!
This is what I wanted to focus on before. Their team fight is impeccable. It's not like they need ultimates to get a team kill or something. They've been playing amazing even without it.
Definitely. I mean, you really can't say that. Look at that. They're trickling in. Taz comes in with the rest when no other teammate are there with him. There comes the Can they take it around? Can they turn it around? But it's an overtime. It's ticking down. They're still holding. They're still stalling. Duke and Sparta are the only one on the only one here on the point. Puffy gets a Dragon Blade. Can he do work? Can he do something? No, he cannot. He doesn't get anything out of it. And gets focused down by King Kebab over there. You cannot reflect that Zarya beam over there, man. But Taz comes in. And throws up a drag. And then Blitz with the Dragon Blade. And they take it. I don't know what even happened in that fight there.
Got such a really fast point. Yeah, they got it once from them, but the thing is, they were able to hold it for such a good long time. Duke with 12 HP, you know, he held the point for like 10 seconds extra. And even in base,
I don't know, man, but they went into a fight with no ultimates, nothing, and then Nightwatch came back and threw everything they had into the fight, but they got nothing out of it. The Graviton and the Winston did work there. Took out One Punch Man, took out both their supports, but they stalled it out without any healers, and then they came back and they pretty much cleared out the point. Insane. Great play. Now, obviously, Sanctum is a very, very, very dangerous man. And as you can see, Racy has pulled out the Roadhog, and we're gonna watch him go up the bridge over there. He's gonna look for those cheeky hooks to throw somebody into the pit for an instant kill. They're going up the bridge trying to do work. Puffy on the soldier over there doesn't insist on the Genji anymore. He's slowly sneaking up on the point, trying to do damage to the backline and onto the Zenyatta. But takes out One Punch Man. Taz gets a pick on Sparta. It's a 4v6. Can they do anything? Racy gets a hook onto Blitz and takes him out, and yes.
That was a really good
Nightwatch call. Will take the point. That was some pretty smart play over there. Puffy just peeked out of the corner and just focused down the supports. And King come up, boops Racy off the map with a Zarya bomb. And they're coming in. Sparta goes in, takes a charge, but he's low on health and he gets focused on. This could go either ways. This could go either ways. Duke takes out Sparta. And they're gonna flip the point around and they take it at 29%. King Kebab going in and he already has a Graviton Surge. That is a very good position to be on, actually. And he already fires it. But there's a Transcendence coming out. Will there be fireworks? No, but Blitz gets Dreadlord and Xerox and Dark Angel. How the hell does that even happen? Through a Transcendence, they win that fight. The Transcendence did nothing for them.
And even while when the fight started after the Graviton, he went to sleep. Kebab was like, he went to sleep, but still, the whole team managed to go through.
And they get nothing from that Graviton. There was nothing. Spartak takes up Taz instead. Zerg takes out Sparta, but it could go over. But Zerg falls off the map! And the control meter keeps building up on 52%. There's a Transcendence coming in. Blitz goes in, gets a little aggressive, tries to take out Dark Angel. It's a tough. Kebab picks up 3 over there. Look at this team. They're all on fire. Blitz is just going ham on that Genji, and he already. And he is looking at them tasty. Racy is nowhere close to that sound barrier. Dreadlord only has 1 nano boost that could probably use defensively or offensively depending on the situation. But look at Blitz and Mannard. They have the Dragon Blade and the nano boost. They could go in any time and wipe them out. And there goes Blitz. He pulls out the Dragon Blade. Is he gonna get anything with it? He takes out Dark Angel and he goes in. Is he gonna take out Racy? No, doesn't get to finish Racy off. But Puffy takes out, Dreadlord takes out, and Taz takes out 3 from them. That seems like a wasted Graviton there over there. King Kebab puffs out the Graviton, but his team is dead. And they flip the control meter over at 33% and overtime. Mannard still held on to that nano boost. Duke, of course, we know has the self-destruct. Can use that to zone out and capitalize. But look at Nightwatch, they have 4 ultimates. It's an exchange of D.Va bombs. Xerox takes out 2 while Duke takes out 1. What in the world is going on in this match anymore? I have no idea.
Are we gonna see a comeback from 99%?
Well, it's not impossible at this point. Look at them, they're holding pretty strong. The D.Va bomb got nothing. Sparta charges into nothing. He leaves 5 of his teammates behind over there. Duke takes out Dark Angel, and that's a bigger chatter. Can they capitalize on it? But Blitz goes on to take out Puffy. And Puffy pops the tag visor and gets nano boosted. But Sparta and King Kebab has picked out 2. And there comes another Graviton Surge. That's a wipe, and they're gonna flip the point over at 93%. Dark Angel trying to stall it out for his teammates over here. Very hard. Racy comes in, he's stalling out. Taz comes in as well. They're coming in, they're trickling in. Is it gonna work out for them? No. Taz gets focused down. Sparta takes out Racy, and they are gonna take Nepal. No! Overtime still trickles out. Xerox, they are stalling this out. But that's it. That's the nail in the coffin
there. No,
it's not! Oh my god, what is this overtime?
Finally,
that stall on overtime was ridiculously long. They tried their best, but unfortunately, Scrublogs take it.
What a fight. There's one more. This round is best of 5. This match, I mean. They need to capture one more point.
We're here on Shrine again. Now we know if Scrub Lords take this map, they're gonna emerge victorious in this match. I would say they engage coming in. Xerox goes on the Reinhardt. It goes a little aggressive over there, gets discorded. Is it gonna get focused down? He's gonna getting healed up. But he does get focused down. Taz Blitz takes out Taz in the back. Xerox is taken out by Sparta. Blitz takes out Dreadlord. That's both supports down for Nightwatch. Racing on the Roadhog takes to take a breather. He's low on health and he gets taken down by Duke. Dark Angel gets a pick on to Sparta and onto King Kebab, but is it gonna be enough? No. Scrub Lords take the point. After a very scrappy fight, however. I don't know if you've noticed it, Mamba, but the team fights haven't really been clean. They have exchange fights, like exchange eliminations, like both ways, like, you know, Scrub Lords getting one or two, or you know, Nightwatch getting one or two, but surprisingly, it's been hard to predict who's gonna get the pick, you know?
But at the end of the day, most of the time what we're seeing is the Genji is the one that's cleaning up. Like when it was Puffy playing Genji, he did the same thing. Blitz has been doing
it. Of course. It's a Graviton, it's a big Graviton, he gets nano boosted.
And he has all
but
the
But they
loot.
Get nothing from it. They get nothing from it. Blitz cleans up again. Dark Angel takes out Anna, but nothing, they hold. That Graviton got them nothing. And they're looking so strong there, 47% and climbing. One Punch Man has the Transcendence. It's going to be very important in the next match. And Blitz has the Dragon Blade and Duke has the Self-Destruct. No, that's not the Self-Destruct. That's the Call Mech Ultimate over there. But he does have the Self-Destruct. This is going to be frightening. Can they utilize his ultimates properly? There is
just
the Transcendence. There's the
go.
Graviton.
Let it go.
And that's a firework. You get three from that Self-Destruct.
I saw that Duke. That BM though.
Oh my god, that's a massacre over there. That's 83% count, and Blitz still holds on to his Dragon Blade. Dreadlord only is close to a nano boost and that's it. Can they do it? Can they make a comeback? Gracie goes on to Winston. But gets taken out by King Kebab. Puffy takes out One Punch Man. King Kebab takes out Zero. It's a 4v6. It's a big Graviton there. Can they capitalize it? No, they cannot. Takes out. It's Blitz gonna. Blitz gets taken out. Dreadlord gets focused down by Sparta. Puffy is on the point trying to hold it in. They do not hold on. Xerox gets charged out of the map. Racy pops at the Primal Rage, trying to contest it. Can he do work? He's discorded. He's getting focused down. Xerox comes back to the point. They're trying to turn it around, but no, he gets focused down. Racy is trying to stay alive. There's a Primal. There's a Graviton there again. Takes out Taz over there. And they take the point. That's gonna be GG. Scrub Lords wins. They have not yet been defeated. They have been undefeated this entire tournament. Blitz once again with the play of the match, of course. Look at that. That's a massacre over there. Even through the Transcendence with Nano Boost and Trap. That's brilliant. Brilliant match. I don't even know what to say. With the Genji, 19,000 damage done, 24% of team's damage taken on a single map. 3-0 on Nepal. That's a lot of work done on the Genji. Fantastic, fantastic match. Scrub Lord looking very strong, very, very, very strong. Can we close the stream then?
Yeah, I'm closing it.